When you think about digital transformation, what does that actually mean in practical terms for an organization like Banco Sabadell?
Okay, first of all, it's not just a digital transformation. It's a transformation of the whole bank, and digital is one important piece. But in fact, we talk about transforming the bank and not just doing a digital transformation. And the branch network is a very important part of that transformation. First of all, let's have a look at why or what is happening, why we are transforming, what is happening out there. There is, of course, a digital revolution, and it is now when a client comes with his or her mobile device into the bank, it has probably more CPU in the hand than the computers which we have there on the desks. And there is this cloud in nearly network bandwidth unlimited, which make it very easy for newcomers to get into that business. So digital is a big trend. Nowadays, we have to think about new ways to make money. And our CEO best described it just this week on a conference. He said, we have to transform our clients from balance sheet consumers to platform users. And that is what it's all about. The bank has to become a platform. And while we keep our business and being the servicer for a lot of transactional business and for the money, we have to become a platform for much more in order to be able to grow and be profitable in the future. We developed our digital platform, and we are continuing to develop it. It's called Proteo, and we are now at Proteo 4, where we build that layer on which we want to create our services to publish them to the outside world. Our ambition is to do it a bit like Amazon. Every service we build should be built in a way that we can use it also for third parties. We're not that, not there yet, but working on that one. And it all moves into ecosystems in both directions. So we will open our interfaces that others can use our bank as a service. For example, we have an ERP provider here in Spain who is directly linking the ERP system with our core banking system, of course, always when the client gives the authorization. But we also want to look in whether we, in our banking offering, in our secure environment, could sell things or give services which are not directly related to our banking offering.
Can you give us an example of the kind of services that you provide to customers that rely on this platform, and why the platform makes it possible to deliver these services in a better way than your competitors?
Okay, so just recently, this Monday, we launched our new wallet application, where we have the classic wallet function of the bank with credit cards, and we added to that the new instant payment platform, which is an industry platform in Spain for instant payment person to person. We integrated that immediately into our wallet platform and into our digital capabilities like electronic signature, fingerprint lock on. So we were able to launch on time with added functionality, and we have seen after a few days that the percentage of adoption to that new service of instant payments via mobile overall in the Spanish banks is higher than our market share. in retail banking. That means we have higher adoption among our clients to that new service than any other bank in Spain. And that was possible by combining this new functionality with existing services and our architecture to build that new app. We developed standard open API for classic account balance, transaction inquiry, money transfer. What we've seen is that on one side we have currently more than 20 startups, but also SMEs who are in the process of adapting to that API and using that API. In the beginning, I told you about this ERP system in the cloud, which is connecting to that. But on the other side, what we have seen, the open API is not only interesting for the outside world. In our innovation labs, for example, we started experimenting with a tangible bank hardware device for clients in the client's home. That means for our own product, we saw, well, the easiest way to build that and to integrate is using the open API. So suddenly the open API becomes an enabler for internal project because it's much easier, much standardized to use that. And that is very interesting. And now this open API will enable us very quickly if, for example, one day things like Amazon Echo are translated to Spanish and will be available in Spain. It would for us be very easy to integrate a thing like Amazon Echo or similar devices to our core systems. In Europe, we have a new regulation, the Payment Service Directive 2, coming up early 2018 will be the date, where banks will be obliged to open APIs for third parties. First of all, we already have it. We have to adapt to these standard interfaces, but we know how to do it. We have to adapt it. But even the more important thing is, for us, it's much more than a regulation. It's an opportunity not only to open our API to other banks, to fintechs, to integrators, but we can start thinking about using our services against the backends of other banks and give services to clients even when they have the account in other banks, for example, with the advantage of being already able to work with such open APIs. And we use data from our more than 250,000 POS devices we have with clients in Spain and analyze that data and give services to our clients to store. So a client of Bank Sabadell with his POS device gets a web page where he can check what is the medium sized ticket of people who are buying in my shop. What is a medium sized ticket of all my competitors around? Of course, anonymized, but always very focused on the business he's running. Extremely useful information. Nobody else can give that data, fully respecting data privacy and security, but extremely valuable for the retail stores.